David Tebbutt and his wife love to travel beyond the beaten track. The beautiful resort they chose, renowned for its privacy, but ultimately so isolated, it cost them his life. The couple, both in their 50s, were the only guests here when gunmen struck, killing David before kidnapping Judith and escaping by boat. Back at their home in a quiet Hertfordshire town, what's happened to them has proved almost impossible to take in. With Judith Tebbutt still being held captive, neighbours are reluctant to speak on camera, worried they might say something which would endanger her further. But they describe the couple as well-liked, friendly, quiet. They go off on a run and be seen doing that regularly, but we're never too busy to stop and chat. The couple had been closely involved with their son Oliver's school. Now in his mid-20s, he's believed to be on his way to Kenya. Here, the head told me, his former teachers have struggled to maintain their composure.
Complete devastation, really. A number of our staff worked with Ollie, who was at school here for 10 years. A busy boy in school, and the parents were here a great deal. They were busy in the local community and were often supporting him on the touchline.
The local vicar sharing his sentiments.
It was just such a shock that this sort of thing could happen, that somebody just been on holiday and having a safari and having a holiday of a lifetime, and suddenly the whole thing has become an act of brutal murder.
The incident on Lamu Island isn't the first time Westerners have been targeted. In 2008, two Italian nuns were kidnapped by Somali gunmen near the border town of El Wak. A year later, three aid workers were kidnapped in Mandera, but were later released. It's feared this could be the work of Al-Shabaab, the militant Islamist group whose training base in Ras Kamboni is near the Kenyan border.
This is a border which is very porous, although officially closed many times, it never really stops people crossing. And be those many people, you know, engaged in perfectly legitimate trade or fleeing the drought in Somalia, but also criminals, smugglers, use this border as well. So this is a very volatile region.
In Lamu, the search operation goes on, the Kenyans having called in the military to help. Working alongside the African authorities, officials from the British Foreign Office, which has appealed to the kidnappers to show compassion. Here in Hertfordshire, those who knew Judith Tullett are trying to remain hopeful, but they're still barely able to believe what's happened to their neighbours. Rachel Younger, Sky News, Bishop Stortford.